All right, we heard a lot about dew point and heat index last week, but just how does high humidity affect our body's natural cooling ability? Well, Sven is here to explain.
So yeah, first we gotta explain a little bit about how our body cools off. We sweat, and then that sweat evaporates. Evaporation is a cooling process, just like when you get out of a lake or a pool, and it's not quite humid, you feel that breeze, right? That moisture evaporating, and that's how our skin cools off. So when we put more water into the air, that natural cooling process diminishes. So you heard a lot about the heat index. Friday, the heat index was about 115. That's what it felt like because our body couldn't cool off. But I'm gonna throw another number at you. It's called the wet bulb temperature. Literally, we wet a bulb, swing it around with a sling psychrometer, it's called, and we see what temperature can that bulb cool off to through evaporation. And it really has a big difference here, the more humidity you have in the air. So when the dew point's 80 degrees like it was on Friday, the most your skin's gonna cool off to is about 82 degrees. So that's why we overheat. But as the dew point drops, we get to levels that we're at today, the temperature on your skin can cool off into the 60s or even cooler. This is all based on a 90 degree temperature. So if the dew point's 40, this is like Palm Springs, think of that. 90 degrees with a 40 degree dew point, your skin can cool off to near 60 degrees just through evaporation. But when we have conditions like we did on Friday, you're not gonna get any cooler than 82. So that's how that cooling process works. And the actual amount of water in the air today, a third of what it was on Friday.
Oh yeah, Chris, so you missed it, but 82 degrees. My body wasn't cooling to like
Persian Gulf.
Yeah,
it was a little
below
much,
90.
Was it? Yeah. Well, I'll take today's weather then.